In this lesson, we're going to add some permissions to our user profile feed view set. These permissions are going to solve two problems for us. First, they're going to ensure that users can only update their own profile statuses. And second, it's going to fix the error we received in the previous lesson when we tried to create a new status update and we weren't logged in. So let's get started. Minimize Chrome and load up the Atom editor. We'll start by creating our permissions class. So load up permissions.py within our profiles API project. We're going to create a new class called postOwnStatus. It's going to be similar to our updateOwnProfile class, but it's going to be checking that the user is trying to update their own status item instead of their own user profile. So start typing the class name, class postOwnStatus will inherit from the base permissions class. So permissions.basepermission. We'll give it the doc string, allow users to update their own status. Just like we did with the updateOwnProfile permissions class, we're going to add a has object permission function, which is going to run the logic to check if the user has the correct permissions to perform the action they're trying to perform. So type def has underscore object underscore permission and give it self request view and obj for object. All right, so we'll give this the doc string checks the user is trying to update their own status. So we want users to be able to view other people's APIs, other people's user statuses, but we don't want them to be able to update or change their user statuses. So we'll type if request.method in permissions.safe underscore methods return true. This way they can view other people's statuses, but they just can't edit other people's statuses. Finally, we'll do return obj.user underscore profile.id equals request.user.id. What this will do is it will check if the user profile ID of the status item they're trying to update matches the request.user.id, which is the same as the user that is logged in right now. If this equals true, then it will allow the action to continue. If this returns false, then it will stop and it will prevent the user from performing that action. Okay, so make sure you save that file. That's all we need to do for our permissions file. Now let's head over to views.py. Scroll to the top of the page and we're going to add one more import here. The import we're going to add is a built-in REST framework permission. This is called isAuthenticated or readonly. So type from REST underscore framework dot permissions import isAuthenticated or readonly. As the name suggests, this gives the user the permission to do anything they want if they're authenticated, but it restricts them to only read-only access if they're not authenticated. So this will fix the error that we had with creating a new status item when we weren't logged in, because after we apply this permission to our view set, you won't be able to create a new object unless you're logged into the system. So scroll down to the bottom where we defined our user profile feed view set. Add a new line below the query set and write permission underscore classes equals. The first permission we'll add is the one that we created. So this is permissions.postOwnStatus. And we'll do a comma and then we'll add the isAuthenticated or read only permission. So this will apply both permission classes to our view set. So it'll only allow them to update and create and modify if they're logged in, or it will restrict them to read only. And then if they try and create a new status or they try and update a status, it will run our post own status permissions class and check that they're trying to update their own status object. Okay, so save the file. That's how we add permission classes to our user profile feed view set. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.